I've done that. But we have made a lot of progress. And I'm saying, yes, I've not denied that we have trade in so many things. For example, purchase of maize. We could have started purchasing maize as early as November. We started purchasing maize in January. We are saying, yes, they suffered for that 1 month. But what will happen now subsequently? With the farmer benefit, those people we are now calling as scrupulous traders, we are separating them. Because we know there are some of those traders who genuinely bought maize from the farmers, they aggregated and sold to national cities and produce board. But we are telling them, this time around, form cooperatives. If you want to come in between, we shall have known that you are the person who bought directly from farmers, the county government signed for it, the area chief signed for it, and then you can benefit. And then we have been able to cut down all those who brought maize from Uganda, those who brought from Tanzania. Because the sense of subsidy, the sense of supporting the farmer, is supporting a Kenyan farmer, not supporting a Uganda or Tanzanian farmer. But if you see, if I bore under pressure, then I will not be able to safeguard our own farm. And I believe you're happy. If you come out of from this region, are you not happy that for the first time we are buying maize from Kenya? And there is no chance of anybody selling maize from Uganda or from Tanzania. Those are some of the benefits that we have been able to get out of this GPS process. It is painful, yeah? But even if you want to get used, you are in ICU, you have to go through the process of ICU, high dependency unit, general ward, then you go for home. This is what we are doing. Now we are no longer on the issue of base, we are in the general ward now.